Hello, welcome again. We are solving some questions of theory of machine. The topic is displacement, velocity and acceleration of frame mechanism. Question number 6 is match the following with respect to spatial mechanism. Type of joint and type of joints are revolute, cylindrical and spherical. Degree of constant 3, 5, 4, 2, 0. Option A P1 Q3 R3, option B P5 Q4 R3, option C P2 Q3 R1, option D P4 Q5 R3. So here, in revolute joint, only degree of freedom is your revolution. We consider total six degree of freedom, 3 revolution and 3 translation. Then only degree of freedom is your revolution about z axis, and rotation about x and y axis is restricted, and linear motion about x, y and z is also restricted, so it has only 1 degree of freedom. Okay, so in cylindrical joint there are rotation either clockwise or anti-clockwise, assuming it has 1, total we are considering 6. Okay, positive, negative, we are not considering separate. So total we are considering 6. So there is 1 revolution about this axis and translation along this axis. No other motion will be possible. Rotation about y axis and z axis is not possible. And linear motion along y and z are also restricted. So it cannot come out. No motion like this, no motion like this. So answer is option C. Okay. Next, the kinematic chain shown in the figure below is, so this is the kinematic chain. Option A structure, option B mechanism with 1 degree of freedom, option C mechanism with 2 degrees of freedom, option D mechanism with more than 2 degree of freedom. So here, this is your suppose this is your fixed link, and this is your 2 link, this is your 3 link, this is your 4 link, this is your 5, this is 6, this is 7, this is 8, and this is 9, and this slider is 10. So total number of links are 10. Okay, and if we count pair, then 1 2 is forming pair. 2, 3 is forming pair, 3, 4 is also 3, 4 is also forming pair, 4, 5 is 4, 5, 5, 6, 6, 7, 7, 8, 9, and 9, 10, and 10, 1. These are the straight pairs. And now other pairs are 4, 7, 3, 8, and 2, 9. These are the total number of pairs are 30. So by using the same formula, that is for degree of freedom with lower pairs, we have degree of freedom as 3 n minus 1 minus 12 or really 1. Okay, so by using number of links and number of lower pairs, degree of freedom comes out to 1. So if we count the number of loops, the other method is, if we count the number of loops, one loop is this, other loop is this, third loop is this, and fourth loop is this. There are 4 loops and number of links are 10. So formula using loop, that f is equal to n minus 2l plus 1, 10 minus 9 is 1. So answer is option B. Okay. Next, question number 8. The kinematic chain shown in figure below is, option A structure, option B superstructure, option C mechanism with 1 degree of freedom, option D mechanism with 2 degree of freedom. So here the number of links are 8 and number of loops are 1, 2, 3 and 4. So using the straight formula, that number of links are 8, number of loops are 4. So 8 minus, if n is the number of links, then n is the number of loops, then 8 minus 2 into 4 minus plus 1, so it will be minus 1, so degree of freedom will be minus 1. So as when the degree of freedom is negative, then it is a superstructure. So answer is option A. Next, question number 9. The degree of freedom of the kinematic chain shown in figure below is. So these are the kinematic chain. This is the kinematic chain option. This is 1, this is 2, this is 3, this is 4, this is 5. Option A 0, option B 1, option C minus 2, option D 2. So the degree of freedom of kinematic chain is. So this is your 1, 2, this is your, if we count number of pairs, 1, 2, 2, 3, 3, 4, and 3, 5, 1, 4, and 1, 5. 1, 4, and 1, 5. Okay. So these are the 6 number of pairs. So formula for degree of freedom is 3, n minus 1, minus 2, p1, or it comes out as 0. Or we count, if we take the number of loops, there are 2 loops. And and the degree of freedom in terms of loop is again that formula n minus 2 l plus 1. So n is your 5 and l is your 2. So it comes out as 5 minus 5 0 by this method also and by this method. So it has 0 degree of freedom. Okay. So answer is option A. Next, the degree of freedom of the kinematic chain shown in figure below is. So now here this load link is parallel to other two links. Okay. So if so options are A 0, B 1, C 2, C minus 2 and D 2. So here if we remove that link, does not affect the mechanism. Okay. So this is your redundant link when it is parallel to these two. If it link, if this link is not there, then the then it will not make any difference. Okay, so we can consider one, the number of links are 4 and number of turning pairs are 4. So so answer is 1. So when a link 4 is parallel to link 5, it does not provide any extra constraints. So the degree of freedom is given by this formula, and we take n as 4 and effective number of pairs are 4. So it does not make any sense to have any parallel link to 2 or 5. So answer is option B. Next, the degree of freedom of the kinematic chain shown in figure below is 1, this is 1, 4, 3, 2, and this is again 6. Option A 0, option B 1, option C minus 2, option D 2. So here in this case there are 4 number of links, 1, 2, 3, 4, that is given, and number of there are 4 number of links, and the lower pair are 1, 4 and 1, 4 and 3, 4 and 1, 2. These are the lower pairs, and number of higher pairs are 3, 2. Only one higher pair is there, so degree of freedom is given by this. And link 3 is your redundant link, because this 4 and 3 constitute the same link. Okay. So this link 3 is your redundant link. So it doesn't make any sense to have this link. We can directly paste this 4 at this answer. So number of degree of freedom is 3, 4 minus 1, minus 2 p1, minus 2 p2 into a part, or degree of freedom will be 1. So answer is your option B.